Now let's look at a question on epicyclic gear train. The question says, in an epicyclic gear train, an arm carries two gears, 1 and 2, having 40 and 50 teeth. The arm rotates at 160 RPM in a counterclockwise direction about the center of gear 1, which is fixed. Determine the speed of gear 2. So we'll do this question with the help of the table. So this is the table in which we have to start with the operations. Okay. The very first operation is that arm is fixed and plus 1 RPM to gear 1. So this becomes 0. Gear 1 goes by plus 1 and this goes minus, I would say, N1, that is 1, okay, into Z2 or Z1 by Z2, Z1 by Z2. Okay, then the next operation would be what? We'll multiply the entire thing by X, that is giving gear 1 X RPMs. Okay, so you will have 0 plus X minus X into Z1 by Z2. Last would be adding Y to the entire motion. You will get Y, X plus Y, Y minus X into Z1 by Z2. Now, the gear 1 is fixed. So, the total motion of this gear 1 would be 0, isn't it? So, you will have X plus Y is equal to 0. Now, what is X? X is the RPM of gear 1, which is 160. So, I will say plus 160 plus Y is equal to 0, which means Y is equal to minus 60. Okay, so arm is going by 160 RPM. Okay, then what is the speed of gear 2? The speed of gear 2 is this. Okay, so N2 is Y minus X into Z1 by Z2. And this is in counterclockwise direction for arm, isn't it? So this would be minus 160 minus X. What is X? It is plus 160 into Z1 is how much? 40 by 50. So, when you find this out, you get a value of minus 228 RPM. So, minus means it is again in the counterclockwise direction. So, it becomes very easy to solve an epicyclic gear train problem with the help of this table. Okay, so I hope you understood this. Now, let's look at one more question on epicyclic gear train.